He only had black. I wanted white because I heard somebody could get white somewhere. But
he could only get black.
Oh. Citrus peeler to the rescue.
Just ask. Hungry.
Tupperware.
Yep, make sure you mention that in your video.
Oh, it's rolling right now. Just do a lot of editing.
You didn't tell me I was on video, you jackass.
You're on video.
I should have done my hair.
It's okay, we can edit it. Yeah, the gaps are getting better now. You want to trade places with me here? Go back to the front and hold it. I think it's going to move. Push it out of your way. Put the hat away. There you go. Gotta clean the schmutz off it. Move on. I thought this was gonna kick my butt. Started off with some help from the family. I told them to go in the house. I bought a couple of these things this morning just so I could handle it. They're actually dent pullers from Princess Auto. Sticked real good. Could not get those suckers to pop off, but it was easy to, from the inside, I was able to put them on and pull while I worked out the seals. So, I'm happy with that. No harm, no foul, let's move on. Last night I managed to take the urethane and I set the new windows into the old frames. Along with the rubber seals. Oh, a couple of shout outs. Sorry for this. I can't remember what your name was, but one fella had mentioned to me about using silicone spray. And oh my gosh, last night I started working these little rubber seals. Well, not exactly little. I was trying to work these into the frame of the quarter window here, and I thought this is not gonna work. I sprayed some of that silicone on it, and they popped in. That was it. There's nothing to it. I'd show you how they open, but I gotta keep them closed while the glue sets up. So I sprayed it on the rubbers for that, and then the other shout out would be for Mr. Heavy Chevy, because any windows I've done before, first of all, they didn't have this curve, so it was a completely different animal, but straighter windows on some of my pickups, I used to use rope or cord, and it would cut or rip or fray. And when he mentioned weed whacker string, I thought, I got that. Man, was that ever slick. Doesn't get hung up, nothing, zip, away it goes. So all the windshields in, guys. I one step closer. It's a nice looking piece of glass. We'll bring you back when I get some more in it. See ya. There you go. We got side glass, front glass. All in one day. I think we're looking pretty good so far. Got all new fuzzies. All new weather stripping. Looking good. I just got the handles here. Got some few years of abuse on them. I'm just soaking them with a little, getting the paint stripper do its thing there. This interior was painted with a paintbrush, so it's kind of got on a little bit of everything. I'll buff them up. They should look like brand new. Surprisingly enough, when I got my truck, there was no vice grips on my window crank or my door knobs. So the splines themselves are still in decent shape, as are the handles. So anyways, guys, we're gonna keep going at it. Might get the back window in today. I still gotta tear apart the passenger side and clean it up. But if I can get to the computer, I will upload my progress so far. See you guys. Playing with the stripper again. Before, I just wanted to mention something here. I mounted this rear view mirror. Now, I know this is not what came in this truck. I know that for a fact. I found this mirror in my parents' basement. It's at your dual for, I don't know what you call it when you got headlights behind you. But that was my father's. Now, I don't know what it was out of, but he was quite the Ford man, so I'm sure it came out of some Ford car. And I've just been hanging on to that for years, even before I had this truck. I just liked this old mirror. So I'm sure it's 50s era, and I wanted to incorporate that into this truck, which wasn't very difficult to do, obviously. I think it may have actually been mounted on a dash on it for a car, but that's where I wanted to put it. So anyways, there it is. See ya.